Today, we will throw light on the effect of so-called bad habits on the meditational practice. Eating meat, eating the flesh of any animal is not a normal phenomena. Flesh is not food. Killing an animal for food, as if you don't have any food available in the nature, is a type of ignorance, is a type of perversion. Whatever that we eat doesn't last for more than 60 seconds on the tongue. The only organ in the body which can taste is tongue. Nothing else in the body can taste. And the taste lasts for only 60 seconds. Once the food crosses the back of the tongue, once it enters the esophagus, there cannot be any taste. So, eating food is basically a requirement than a luxury. And the luxury, if at all it is a luxury, is so transient. And for this 60 second pleasure, an entire industry called as hotel industry came into emergence. Only for a 60 second pleasure. That is the reason why Krishna told Yukta Ahara Viharasya. That means Ahara and Vihara need to be Yukta. Right, proper. Right food for the human body is natural food. With plenty of water, plenty of salads, plenty of fruits, plenty of grains and pulses. Cooked or uncooked. But eating flesh, killing their beautiful animals. Animals are superior to human beings. They are only body and souls. They don't have any minds. That is the reason why buffaloes are all very happy. Buddhas are also very happy. The people who are living between buffalo and a Buddha are unhappy. Because all these people have minds. Buffalo is equivalent to Buddha. No difference at all. Both have only bodies and souls. But the buffalo, animal buffalo, so innocent, so trusting, so loyal to human beings that it offers even death for the sake of loyalty. Such an animal we are killing. If not we kill, at least we are eating what is killed for us. So meat eating is not a proper habit. Then comes smoking. Smoking is injurious to health. Smoking is also a pleasure, a great pleasure. People who smoke knows the greatness of this pleasure. A puff after a beautiful lunch is so relaxing. A puff after a dinner is extremely relaxing. It stimulates the central nervous system. Same with alcohol. A chilled glass of beer in a hot summer is a great luxury. A glass of wine after a hard day is always relaxing. But having a cigarette, having a glass of wine, when it is not a real requirement, when it is really not needed, when you are really peaceful and tranquil, is basically a reflection of one's excitement. Excitement is one extreme of happiness. On the other extreme of happiness is depression. When the pendulum is exactly the meridian, without moving towards excitement or depression, we never need a cigarette or a glass of wine. But if you really want to enjoy, no problem. On and off. Habituation, dependence, turns to substance abuse. Our happiness becomes dependent. And our happiness moves from original source, that is hara, to extraneous sources. If you try to find happiness from any source other than one's own self, is always pathological and wrong. Happiness is a state of consciousness which is always within, irrespective of any external situations whatsoever that we are in. And sexual contact a pathological dependence, a maniac level of dependence, are making physical sex as the only source of happiness which exists for some people is again a pathology. Staying at one's own meridian, leading a balanced life, not getting excited with what one gets, not getting depressed for what one loses, is a natural outcome of connecting with one's hara. When there is sustained attention at one's hara, life becomes very simple. Thinking becomes very simple. Whenever you want to think, you think. The emotional garbage gets empty. You are pure. And you will become a source of changing the psycho-spiritual matrix governing the human consciousness of the world. That's what the grid has been created, to raise the consciousness of the psycho-spiritual matrix of this globe. The group size may be very small, but it is going to be very, very, very powerful. Be at your center, be at your meridian, always, in any given situation. Thank you.